Hello. This video gives you a quick overview of the current state of particle systems in Blender EEVEE 2.8 Alpha 2. First, I have to tell you that all of this is still extremely buggy. Blender crashes a lot and not many things actually work the way you would expect them. Here is what I found out to be usable by playing around for hours. Let's start with a particle emitter and a couple of lights. I want to emit simple icospheres, so let me create one and set it as the object to render. I also set it to smooth shading and hide it in the viewport and render. I turn up the emission number to 30,000. Turn off gravity, add a turbulence force field and set the strength to 5. Now when I hit play, we get an interesting looking flow of objects. I also change the particle lifetime to basically forever and have them emitted in the first 100 frames, so we have all 30,000 spheres in the scene after frame 100. I also turn up the random size to 0.8, set the playhead to frame 120 and rotate the viewport. This is pretty crazy. We're looking at 30,000 spheres in real time. Just to compare it to the speed of cycles, let me switch over quick. This is really not real time. Okay, back to EEVEE. So far so good. Now I want to try to randomize the material a little. Something I like to do in cycles is this. First, I create a new material for the icosphere and mix in an emission shader. And use the random value of the object info node piped through a color ramp. What I want is to set, for example, 5% of all spheres to the emission shader. But we can see that this does not work in EEVEE yet. When I switch to cycles, here this works as expected. I've also tried the outputs of the particle info node. None of these seem to work at the moment. It seems the only output with a usable value is the location of the object info node. Sadly, path rendering doesn't work yet, and the convert button of the particle system modifier doesn't do anything. Let's try hair now. I change the particle system to hair and render as to path. For decent hair in EEVEE, we have to change the setting in the render tab to strip and additional subdiff to 2 or 3 to round off the hair strands. Also, this is pretty crazy again, looking around 30,000 hair strands. I turn down the emission number to 3000 and add interpolated children. Turn up the clump strength and add a braid kink type and increase the amplitude a little. Here again we can see all the changes in real time in the viewport, which is very nice to work with. The material of the hair strands comes from this setting, which is one of the materials of the cube. Let's try it the same thing like before. Using the random output of the now hair info node and a color ramp with constant interpolation, we make a view of the strands emissive, which does work. Also, using the intercept output and a color ramp, we can change the color along the strands. I have spent several hours trying to get some useful animations with hair dynamics, but this is still very buggy. Some force fields work with hair dynamics, sometimes hair dynamics have to be on, sometimes off. Sometimes baking dynamics works, sometimes it doesn't. The viewport mostly shows something completely different from the final render. For example, particles are in a totally different location no matter if you baked it or not. All of this is still a bit frustrating to use because it is so random and hard to say what is usable and why. Of course, this is all still in the Alpha 2 version and we should expect things to improve drastically. So to keep this video short, let me summarize that like in my other videos before, it is amazing how fast EEVEE renders everything. And the things that already work in 2.8 work really well. Now, just for giggles, let's turn the crazy up to 11. Emit 5000 particles, have 50 children per particle. So now we're looking at 250,000 hair strands in real time. I enabled a volumetric world with a noise texture for the density for a more random look. And switch on bloom, because why not? This speed is just amazing. I am looking forward for 2.8 to get more of the features I have become used to in the past years, and also to be more stable. Just think physics simulations of hundreds of thousands of particles rendered in no time? Wow, can't wait. I will keep trying daily builds of Blender 2.8, and when more particle and physics features work, I'll make another video to show you. Please like, comment, and subscribe for more Blender videos. Thank you for watching. See you soon.